History's shown it's pretty tough to go from rugby to league. Although if you're the right sort of person, with the right sort of personnel behind you, it can be done. Although sometimes you wonder whether Matthew Ridge has signed a league contract or a contract to be a movie star. You know, horror movies and all that. Ridgey was an All Black fullback, and he was probably on his way to being one of the best. He had all the skills, but more than that, he had the determination to get to the top. Well, he got there, twice. First with us, and then with those other blokes with the money.
Decided to pursue a career in rugby league. It's basically all it is.
Oh, I'm on my way, I know I am. Somewhere not so far from here. All I know is all I feel right now. I feel the power growing in my head. Sitting on my own, not by myself. Everybody's here with me. I don't need to touch your face to know. I don't need to use my eyes to see.
Just nice and close together once again.
Yeah, good.
That's it.
Okay. Good.
Cool. This is nothing, is it?
This is just the beginning.
Manly Rugby Leagues Club, Matthew's new home. And guess who came to dinner? Yep, me. Not for cash, but for curiosity.
What they, you know, they staple you up.
So what is your view?
Staple you up.
Yeah, it just looks like a zip.
I looked at the blind and I said, oh,
please.
Is this the year, is it? That's your gear. That's our jumper for the season, of course. So just I'll try it on and see if it goes. See how it works. In fair shape. Oh, a bit skinny.
Oh yeah, no, it's a bit sweat. Yeah, if you look the part, good. I was covering it. Yeah, nah, I like it quite big anyway. Should probably shrink. I mean, I'm not too good in the wash, mate, so. Well, mate, you're gonna have to get used to it. Part of the deal. I'll have to find my mother over here now. All right, Ridge, your rugby pufta. That's not gonna be like that.
Matthew's new home ground is the Brookvale Oval. It's about the size of Manawatu's Palmerston North Showgrounds.
It's a soft ground, eh?
And this is no field for the faint-hearted.
No, it was over by the... Oh, here we go, here we go. This is just a little thing.
This is what hardens these guys up, eh?
They're real hard, hard men, these chairs, playing on stones. Still, should be good.
The facilities aren't Eden Park. Possibly because they spend $1.5 million
on
players.
See, that's where all these hard asses get the stones and that off them from the fields, isn't it? But that must be pretty tough.
League lesson number one, how to play the ball.
Awesome. You've got to stone your feet, you tosser.
No, you can do that.
You can't.
Yes, you can.
You've got to stone
your
feet.
See, I'll be expecting them to go for it, right? See, so once they lift and have a go, that's when I'll go for a play, because if they go like this, right, I mean, it's going
to
take
them... I don't know how they do it. I mean,
I watched Roberts do it. I watched Roberts do it on Friday night, and he got pinged, because he was going like this, right? And the guy just waited him to do it, because, you know, they know he's going to do it. And he'd do it, and then he'd just go down then, because he hasn't got enough time to get back again. See, I'll probably go like this, and they'll go, thank you very much. And a good transition made by Matthew Ridge. And Cronulla are thanking Manly.
The player of the day for Cronulla was Matthew Ridge.
And he gets his win bonus from Cronulla. It's yours.
Let's go to McDonald's, eh?
Matthew thought it would be 5 years before he could get an All Black test jersey.
Yeah, hello?
Then came the second bombshell to hit New Zealand. And Ridgey.
Who's that? Full Love, Evening Post, yeah. How are you?
Not too bad, not too bad. The Leeds Rugby League coach is meeting with Kipper. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I suppose it's a bit of a surprise, really. I don't know, a bit of a shock. I suppose if Kipper went, there'd be a bit of a bombshell in New Zealand, but, yeah. I mean, it's his decision. How do I think Kipper would go at Lee? Well, I don't know, mate. I mean, I can't say how I'm going to go at Lee yet, so I'm not up to judge someone else, but obviously, you know, he's fast, he's pretty brave. Yeah, I mean, if he wants to do it, he wants to do it, but, I mean, yeah, sure, it's a bit of a fright, that's for sure. Obviously, things are happening pretty fast, so... I don't know, mate. Oh, yeah. Good one. Yep, bye-bye.
So what did you say?
Said, said the guy flew from Heathrow on Saturday night or something, was getting in today, and that he was definitely talking to him.
I wonder what Chris was saying.
Yeah, what a time to go, though, do you believe it?
I can't believe that. If he goes, if that's like tonight, what's the time now at home? 20 past 8, so he's either signed or he hasn't.
Yeah, well, he was speaking to the guy this afternoon, so...
would be amazing.
Oh, mate. New Zealand will just be freaking out, mate. I wonder what Kipper's going through, though. Apparently they can't get a hold of him.
Well, you should know what he's going through.
Oh, I know what he's going through, but I mean...
What is he going through?
What is he going through?
Yeah.
What do you go through?
What have I done?
No, to tell you the truth, you probably do think that. Like, after I'd signed, I couldn't sleep. You know, I went to bed that night and I woke up. You know, I was waking up every 5 minutes thinking, oh my God, what have I done?
Yeah.
But when it all came down to it, I woke up the next morning and I was happy.
Yeah.
I thought, what are you worried about? You know, you've always wanted to do it. And it's not, you know, like, obviously the money's an attraction, but so I've always wanted to be a professional sportsman.
But it can't finish there, surely. Okay, you get up the next morning, and then, I mean...
Oh, sure.
I felt for you when you had to get up in front of the team, you know.
I didn't think, to be honest, I didn't think I'd cry or anything like that. And I mean, I did.
But that's good. I mean, that's
that just came out, and that was good. I mean, like, the guys knew that leaving them wasn't going to be an easy thing. And that I was, you know, I'm eternally grateful to those guys for what they did, because I wouldn't be here without them.
And was that the hardest thing? What's the hardest thing of leaving the game of rugby?
That? Leaving the guys, yeah. I mean, because you're so close, I mean, you know.
Yeah, I do, yeah.
I mean, how close did we get on the orbit tour?
Yeah, that's right.
I'll be going to play for the rugby league club Leeds, north of England. I'll be flying out on Wednesday. I'll be in Leeds to tie a few things up there, even though everything's confirmed.
I didn't think he was going to leave. But I guess now a lot of people will be saying, would have Matthew gone if he knew Kipper was going? But it might have changed my point of view, in the sense that I would have liked to have played a test had I been selected. But I think in the long run, I still would have gone to Lee. I don't think I might have waited around for the World Cup if I was good enough and my form was good, but I've always wanted to play league. The opportunity arose, and I weighed up what I thought were the conditions and the situation at the time, and here I am.
We've got a new signing in Matthew, and it's just an informal or a formal, whatever you want. Welcome to the club, Matthew. Matthew's an All Black, or an ex-All Black. And I'm sure he's going to make it as a rugby league international as well. And I've told him he's come to a fine bunch of modest, well-mannered fellas. And I'm sure he'll enjoy his stint here, Matthew. So just welcome to the club, right? Just so you don't get embarrassed, you've just got to say a couple of words for them.
Thanks very much. It's good to be here. I'll be doing my best.
Welcome to training at the Manly Rugby Leeds Club, and it's time for Matthew Ridge to start his new job. Guess it's be nice to the new boy time. Whether or not you think Ridge's made the right decision, after a few minutes, it's obvious he's gone with the right coach.
Hold the pad high, Matthew. Hold it high. Just the taller one.
She tickles, I tell you.
Good. Any close marking he'll be able to avoid because of his balance and his running. Yeah. You know, he will get nailed a few times, but he gets nailed in rugby union. If he runs in the wrong place in a game of rugby union, he'll get flattened, and the same thing will happen in rugby league.
This training method is actually game related, so all the stuff here will sort of start clicking into place.
Yeah. One of the things that impressed us about Matthew was his balance and his running and gliding and his evasive skills, and he will adapt good as gold to this type of thing, because obviously he's not a giant, but he can use his balance and his speed to good effect in evasive methods, because he will be up against stronger defence than he's ever seen before. You know, it will be a lot more difficult from coming into a rugby league back line than what it is in a rugby union back line because of the defence. If you're calling roach or punch, Matthew doesn't know what they are yet. He'll pick up the runner. They'll come like this, and you just watch that. Yeah, you just watch that bloke. Just look like that, and there should be just someone on either side.
Yeah.
You know, so because you have to look on both sides of the of your defence as well. You know, if you're like that, you'll get stuck. Just look along the line, so that you're not like that. You know, you never turn your back. Don't turn your back. Yeah. Just go back and just look along the line. There'll be someone down either end.
Tackle bags, Matthew. Something you'll have to get used to, because tackling is definitely part of your newfound vocation.
Owen.
Owen.
Just saying that with like the tackle bags at home, you know, you don't get any rest there. Basically, you do like 16 whatever tackles you do. Yeah. At home, we tackle one, go back, and then they go through the team, sort of, you know.
When we're having a condition.
Quite bugging, mate. Are you quite like, are you bugging?
No, I'm not bugging, but I mean, you find that your heart rate's going all the time, you know. You haven't got time to sort of go back and go.
If we have a conditioning night, he's liable to do, say, 70 or 80 tackles, you know, in one night.
Yeah.
It's just, as he said, it's contact, you know, for his heart.
It's just hitting the bag, hitting the ground, and pulling yourself up, you know, running back all the time, you know. Yeah. I mean, you think about when I'm playing rugby, I might make two tackles a game.
That's because we never let anyone through, Ridgie. Of course, while Matthew's learning the realities of rugby league, it's time for his Manly teammates to size him up.
About that today, you know, they're very enthusiastic and they're very keen to learn. And you know, that's two priorities and two things that you need. Now, obviously, I suppose the test will come when he plays his first game. But you know, he's young, you know, and he's enthusiastic, so I don't think I'll have too much trouble.
Matt Wellman for you.
Hi.
Start somewhere, I suppose.
Yeah.
Well, the hardest thing for Matthew is that he hasn't got any experience at this stage. The more experience, it's the same with any sport, you know, tennis, whether it be tennis, golf, what have you. The more experience you get, the better you become, the more proficient you become. Matthew's obviously got all the basic skills, and he just needs a few games under his belt. But having seen tapes of him playing for Auckland, I've got no doubt in the world that he'll be a very successful rugby league player.
Come on, Ridgie. Training wasn't that tough. Luckily, he's arranged medical insurance before his first game.
We're going to play Matthew in first team, first up.
So you better get me right.
Nothing like a bit of pressure.
Into it.
Has that not been heard of before? If someone playing like straight away in the top?
I can't recall any, can you?
Yeah. No, I don't.
Normally they play them in reserve grade for
Maddie Burke.
Half a dozen games or so. I think Michael played
He played
St George, I think he played
three or four games,
yeah, in reserve grade. The trouble is, if you make a mistake in the first grade, everybody says, you know, you've made a mistake. But if you make the mistake in reserve grade, they'll say, you know, he can't play, or it's going to take him ages to change or whatever. He might do the goal kicking as well, just for a bit of extra pressure.
Yeah.
Have you kicked, Matty? Oh, better start training, eh?
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Mm.
So you're 21?
Yeah.
Right, and how long have you been playing union?
Since I was 15.
Mm. What did you play before that?
Soccer.
Mm.
Soccer and a lot of tennis.
Right. And you've never played any league? You haven't played one full game of league?
No. I've never pulled a league jersey on in my life.
So when they put one through the ground, where's the full, am I behind the line? Am I behind the line of defence? Yeah. So I'm just sort of hovering at the back.
Yeah, see, that's only 10 metres out from the line. Yeah. So you just stay on the goal line.
Yeah.
And when they get closer, you just... Well, it just depends where they are. Sometimes you'll have to come up and stand on the line.
Yeah.
If you see a weakness, you just get up in the line.
Yeah.
But you just have to try and keep away from where the forwards are.
Yeah. He shouldn't have got... The winger came taking in to take back, and then trying to stop the pass, he should have just hung off, you know?
Yeah. You've got to stay out with your own man. Yeah. So that's what I was saying to you about the fullback. You have to just...
Oh, they come line.
Yeah, you just have to follow wherever Docking goes. Yeah. You just go out with Docking.
Yeah.
And the moment he puts his, you know, the moment he's through the line, just bang, nail him. See, you know what I was saying to you about how they don't cover the whole field?
Yeah.
Graham Lowe has a real natural manner. Though, of course, a coach can't be Mr. Nice Guy all the time.
If anyone comes out here and just starts on the kicking program, we're struggling enough with bloody injuries. Get out here and get warmed up. If you come straight out and kick straight away, you will be dropped from the side. No ifs or buts. Round the outside, everybody.
Yeah, it's about time everyone stopped being so nice, especially to Ridgie, because now he's about to find out what rugby league is all about.
Matthew, out on your knees. Welcome to the big time, buddy.
About the only thing rugby and league training have in common is we both throw a ball around. Perhaps not quite as intense as Auckland or the All Blacks, more like a club session, which after all, Manly is. They tend to do things a lot differently to us, but before I show you, can the All Black selectors please turn off their TV sets for 10 minutes? Yeah, thanks. Don't want them getting any ideas.
Take it out, have a rest. First one, over the boxes. Over the first, over the second, over the third, over the fourth, over the fifth, straight down, over to the next exercise. Weight on the chest to start. Step up, press up, lower down, step down. Good exercise. Down, weight on the chest, up, back down again. Ready to try. Weights up. I'm not seeing any aggression.
I'm not seeing the up-tempo intensity I want to see. Maybe you don't like it. Maybe it hurts too much. You guys are professionals. You get on with the job. You train harder. A bunch of heathen wolves, and not that you guys are out of the ball game. Quite often, two of you are more than too proud to work another bloke over. I understand why it happens. The fact is it happens. It's going to happen here right now. Matthew, out on your knees. Welcome to the big time, buddy. Jeff, come out. Bad luck, out here. You recovered?
OJ. Yeah.
Set of gloves. Whack them on. Out here. Matthew?
Yeah.
Just so that they know who the target man is, shirt off, please. Two. Two on, shirt off. Just whip her off.
Okay, go.
Ido, you guys give him bulk support because he needs it. Out.
Who's on there?
Jeff? Your name?
Owen.
Owen, out you come, buddy.
Melbourne.
Face him. Melbourne, sorry. Ido, Matthew, it's you and them. Fellas, punch the head of him. Give him a dead set fucking hiding. I want you to be as spiteful and as nasty and as aggressive and vindictive as you possibly can. Matthew,
yeah.
For 30 seconds you give all. Because this happens on the field, and whether you like it or not, those guys mean more than these guys mean. They're just going to put in as much as they can. Move in, headlocks together. Heads locked together. Ido, you two guys don't give him 100% full flat-on hiding. You guys go up the rope and he gets away with it. Matthew, you don't defend yourself as much as you possibly can and put in a heart-girdling effort. You go up the ropes. Give him support, fellas. They need it. Ready? Now work at it, Matthew. You work your life out. You work as hard as you can. Set!
Teared it up, the army instructor that we had, to pick on Matthew first. Because, and I did it not to try and belittle Matthew or anything like that. I did it to try and let the other players see that Matthew had plenty of ticker. And that is the key, you know, he's got plenty of ticker. And he got put in a situation where two blokes got, you know, he was having to... it's just body punching against two other players, and it's very, very demanding on you physically. But he was able to, quite apart from the exercise, he was able to come out of that with plenty of dignity. And I know that the players were very, very pleased the way that Matthew handled himself in that situation. There was no, he didn't try and get out of it at all. He went through it. It was a tough initiation for him, but he handled it well.
Oh, beauty. He felt better.
Mine.
Get away from me, Rich. Virgil Camp.
After that dignified beating, you could sense that Ridgie had won the respect of his new teammate, which is always important. Matthew has a sort of never-back-down mentality that on first impressions may be like fingernails on a blackboard. But once you get to know him, you can't help but like the guy, as the Manly players are finding out. Still, the only way to really earn their complete respect is by performing on the football field. And that day is about to arrive.
Hello. G'day. JK. How are you, mate? Oh, I'm pretty nervous. But I'm looking forward to it now. It's about time that the day's rolled around, so I'm looking forward to it. Oh, for sure. No, I'm happy I'm here now. I'm in a good place. I've got a car, got a job. I'm settling down really well with the team, so it's just all up to me now. So, you know, I'm really looking forward to it. It's a couple of hours away now, so. Good. No, the guys have they've accepted me really well, so I think it's going well. But I've got a nickname that I'm not too keen on. First of all, it was Lightning, which there's a place called Lightning Ridge up here or something like that. So one of the rubbers called me Lightning, and now they've got Virgil. And I think that's a guy off Thunderbirds A Go or something, but I haven't even seen the program, but apparently it's not too hot. So that's the only down trail. I want to play well. I mean, I don't just want to get through the game and it be, oh, yeah, he did all right. You know, I want to get through and people think, shit, he's going to do it, you know. So I want to play well. I mean, it is going to be difficult, but I've just got to hang on to the ball and run, really. It's a lot different, I think. I had, you know, with the ABs, you had all the guys around you. You know, you're on tour and the feeling came together in the team and obviously it had built up for a long time, whereas this has been fairly quick and it still sort of hasn't sunk in that at 3 o'clock I'll be, you know, pulling on a rugby league jersey and going out and playing rugby league. But so it's a little bit different, but I think I'll prepare for it, but only time will tell, really.
Well, thanks, Pete. You're very hot property, Matthew. Obviously, everybody wants to get you before the match, which doesn't do your nerves any good, and we're still being taunted by a television camera crew from New Zealand. How are the nerves?
Oh, not too bad at the moment. Obviously, when I get out there, I'll be feeling them a bit, but it's just pressure. I like pressure, so I'll give it a go.
Matt, I don't think it's any secret to you, but the Cronulla players have made it pretty clear that they're really going to give you a nice old introduction to rugby league today.
Oh, well, I wouldn't want it any other way, I suppose. I'm giving it a go, mate. I can't do any more than that.
Mate, you even know their names. It sounds good to me. Matt, have a really good match today. I know it's a very difficult occasion for you, and thanks for talking to me so close to the match. Good luck.
Not a problem. Thanks.
Back to you, Pete.
Beauty. All
right. Thanks, Matt.
I was a hell of a lot more nervous when I played for the All Blacks. Really, really nervous. Different feeling, very exciting.
Thank you. and Rich flies beautifully and takes it.
John, how did you place your ball?
Well, it's all Manly at the moment. There's Low sending messages down. You can hear the message being passed on. Well, it looks like it could be good value. Pick one up, 24-8. Well, Matthew, how'd you find it out there? Pretty hard, pretty tired. It's good to get through it though.
They certainly hit me hard, and they're good, and I'm knackered.
Well, a little bit about you, so what are you weighing?
82.
82?
Yeah.
You must have bricks in your pocket.
I'd like to thank New Zealand for helping me along. They didn't give me a hard time when I decided to change codes. It was very positive, and I thank all the media and especially the Auckland team and the All Blacks for that support.
Well, Matthew, your Auckland and All Black teammates were sad to lose you, but we knew if rugby league was what you wanted, then you wouldn't let yourself down.
Thank you very much.
He's coming now. Thanks, Matty. Come on, mate. Good play.
Crack on, baby. No worries.
Hey, Carter, come in.
You get hit so many times, you get up and you play the ball like you see in rugby union. I get tackled maybe two or three times in a match, and then it's not sort of front on, slam bang, you know. Oh, I loved it, eh? Just
nice. How was your leg?
Good, didn't feel it at all.
Matthew, I never come into the dressing room, but I came in particularly today to say how pleased I am with the way you played. Your debut in the rugby league has just been sensational.
That's right.
Graeme has always told me you're a great player, but I didn't realise just how good you were. Anyway. And you know the big thing that's on your side? Yeah. Plenty of courage. Plenty of that, mate.
Thanks, mate. Thanks very much.
It was a fantastic performance, and
hopefully it won't be my last.
I tell you what, I'm absolutely delighted with the way you played. I think you've done
Goal kicker as well, isn't he?
You've done New Zealand proud, and you've done Graeme Lowe proud, because he's spoken so highly of you, and you've just vindicated his judgment.
The coach's award today in first grade goes to Matthew Reach. Just like the same. Hey,
To the Manly Club, to the guys in the team today, thanks very much. You've really warmed to me and you helped me through today, and I thank you very much. Thanks.
That was supposed to be the end of the story, until Matthew decided on a trip home. After five games of rugby league, his next appearance would be for New Zealand. Meet the Kiwi Rugby League team. And it's time for them to meet their new fullback.
Naturally, we'd like to welcome the new members to the party, Matthew Ridge, and I hope you've all introduced yourself to Matthew. We haven't had a chance to do that Matthew, is there anybody that you haven't met?
Virgil off the Thunderbirds because he's a sprite, he looks like a little puppet.
And I'd like to take the camera over here to George Mann.
Mark, that's got to be the worst haircut ever, Horro.
H. Pick up the gone. Hideous.
Hideous. My name is George Mann. You're Gulam Mahara. Prepare for your dive deafness. Him and Munster.
It's not the good, the bad, and ugly,
just,
is it?
Just out of the Munsters. Let out for a week.
Everyone needs to know, especially in the ruck area, the forwards need to know where they are as far as defence, where their numbers are.
Yeah.
You're going to have to tell everyone, get to know everyone's first name. Yeah. Tell them to slide right, slide left, or whatever.
Yeah.
But you've got to make sure that the holes are filled up from behind, because you're in the best position to see. There you go.
While there's no argument about Matthew Ridge's abilities to play Test Rugby League, some league people aren't entirely happy with union converts cruising into Test positions so quickly. It's up to Matt to convince the doubters he's worth his place in an international league team.
I know, he's got desire. He's just, over the last week, I've seen that he's got the will to win. He wants to do well. He wants to improve all the time. As you said earlier, guys who have changed over so far have changed over, for the money side of things. And as you say, they mightn't make it because they've only changed just for the money.
Do you find it annoying that whenever you came, especially back home, that all people want to talk to you about is how much you're earning? I mean, that's all.
How much we're not earning?
Yeah, how much you're not earning.
Players don't make anywhere near what they're quoting in the papers. Nowhere near it.
No, and everyone works just like...
Yeah, well I do. I know Huey does. Probably most of the players at Balmain, I'd say there's 99% of them all work. The only guy that doesn't work is Andy Carrier, who's come out from England. They have to work because there's only two payments a year, one in July and then one in October. So you've got to sort of fit yourself around your lifestyle around when you're actually going to get that money. There's no weekly payments of your win bonus or anything like that.
People don't realise that you also got to pay 50% in tax.
Yeah.
So it's half gone straight away.
It makes it very hard if you didn't have a job. Otherwise, you'd go broke.
Obviously, getting paid to play isn't the perfect answer. But Auckland training in these conditions, the freedom to earn even a bit of money would make this a bit more bearable. Correct, Brett. Now halfback for Bradford Northern. And it seems we have another league scout amongst us. Manly's Matthew Ridge, who's popped into Eden Park to reminisce on how it used to be.
I don't know, it seems a really long time since I was here, so it's a bit of a novelty, really. It's weird. It's real weird. But no regrets, though. It's so different. It's not even funny. I didn't realise you don't realise how different it is till you come back and have a look.
Check my bag out. You want it tight on there? There's never been any ill feeling towards Matthew making the move. In fact, all of us were looking forward to watching his first test for the Kiwis.
You going? Yeah.
There's always something special about playing your first test match. And just because it's rugby league and not union, as they say, it doesn't matter. The Auckland team and probably most rugby union players all hope Ridgey does well, because after all, he is playing for New Zealand.
Come on, 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 come on
back now. I put a powerful wind in my hair. Gonna wind up where you started from.
And Matthew Rinsler must be disappointed, but Great Britain win the series. They were the underdogs when they came out. No one gave them a chance. And these young Lions have done it.
Matthew Ridge, you have to be happy with his performance. He kept New Zealand in the game.
Ridge kicked 10 points in his first test match, and he also proved he's much more than just a goal kicker. Still, his team had lost, and that's never a great feeling, no matter how well you play.
You could see the guys were dropping off, and the forwards were just getting tired. Because we were putting them down there, we were doing everything right, when we were up by 2 points, and I'd kick the ball down, we'd be right in there. And they started it in here.
Yeah.
You know, it's
hard, looks hard work though. Oh, it's up and down, up and down.
The biggest mistake I made is when they scored the try over there, I had a drink of water. And mate, it's just wicked stench over there. Yeah, the last 20 minutes, man, it's really hanging out there.
So, like, what's the difference between fullback for the All Blacks and fullback for the Kiwis? Everything.
Everything, yeah. There's a big difference. It's a lot more on your own. You know what I mean? Like, in rugby, you've got the back three, you know, like, always talking, always that. Yeah, there you're always on your own. The thing that pissed me off about that kick, the wind in the first half was taking the ball across the face. So I just aimed it right towards the right hand up to my top. As soon as I kicked it, I thought, yep, when's it going to paint the head? It's going to fucking straight out. And it just kept on going, and just there was no wind. The wind just stopped, mate. Right? If there just hadn't been a little bit of wind, mate, it would have just gone. Oh, slow down, I couldn't believe it. Just kept on going.
How close was that kick on the sideline?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Someone's picking it to an arbor.
Nah, missed it, you know, like it missed it by that much. Went out that way.
Didn't what?
It was ugly, eh? You were going, you'll be right. I was going, yeah, I'm fine. You've
never been better.
I'm sure losing a rugby league test is not much different from losing a rugby union test. It feels a little bit like lying on the beach with a rock poking into the middle of your back. In other words, it hurts. Any sportsman can relate to that. No one likes losing. Not even for professionals like Matthew Ridge.
Oh, sorry, mate.
But I guess, at least now, he's a true rugby league player.
Sucks, man. Missed out on a winning bonus.
But for the second time, just when we thought it was all over, what happens? The story takes another twist. In the next test against Britain, Matthew kicks 6 out of 6 and plays a major role in the Kiwis' third test victory. So while this program may be coming to an end, it seems the story of Matthew Ridge has a long way to go.
All of the All Blacks.
Oh, okay. Want to go home yet?
Nah.
But it's not what I expected, really, to be honest.
Yeah,
You've already answered that, Jeffrey.
Are you feeling nervous?
How the hell are you composed? Yeah, go.
Just keep on pushing hard, boy. As
you leave, you wind
away.
Sorry.
What's this like?
No, I think it's not what I expected.
What are you laughing at?
Nah, it's not. So, yeah, that's not. It's really dropping.
I was really trying, you know, and you just jerked me, man.